My name is Emily Brignone. I'm affiliated with the Informatics Decision Enhancement and Analytic Sciences Center at VA Salt Lake City. And I'm also an incoming Health Services Research postdoctoral fellow at the Center for Health Equity Research and Promotion at VA Pittsburgh. Precision medicine is a medical model that emphasizes the tailoring of healthcare decisions and practices and services to unique and individual patient needs. So precision medicine is usually thought of in terms of things like biomarkers and genes, but at the VA we have the opportunity to really extend this approach to include a focus on a broader range of factors that are related to health. So this can include things like military service experiences and exposures during military service, as well as certain social determinants of health. The VA serves a really diverse population of veterans, not only in terms of demographics, but in terms of experiences in the military and unique health risks and health-related needs. And in terms of the most recent cohort of veterans who have returned from conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan, some of them come home from service and transition into civilian life just fine and don't really have many issues. But there are others who do encounter certain challenges. And these can include challenges that are related to physical and mental health, or employment issues, or family issues, or economic issues. In order to be responsive to these issues and really meet their needs, we have to engage them in care that is responsive to those specific needs. In doing so, we can help to mitigate some of the health disparities that we see among this population. We've recently learned that veterans who are discharged from service for reasons that aren't routine, so reasons other than expiration of term of service or retirement, these veterans tend to be vulnerable to a range of adverse outcomes in the post-deployment period. And among veterans of recent conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan, about 30% are discharged under these non-routine conditions. And the most common reason for this is disability. And this can be physical health issues or mental health issues, but they were severe enough that the service member was unable to continue in the line of duty and they were discharged. And many of these veterans make their way to the VA following their discharge from service, and they receive health services treatment, and many of them also receive service-connected disability benefits. And these benefits are intended to offset any income that may have been lost as a result of these disabilities that were related to their service. And what we found is that although many of these service members who are discharged due to disability are receiving these service-connected disability benefits, they're actually at a higher risk for homelessness in the post-deployment period. And so while we found that there was some protection offered by these service-connected disability benefits, it doesn't fully mitigate the risk that's associated with being discharged due to disability. We've learned from these recent studies that it seems that we need to pay more attention to their long-term needs, because results from this study indicate that when they first return home from service, they seem to be doing okay, and their risk for homelessness isn't any higher than those who were discharged under routine conditions. But as time goes on, their risk for homelessness increases and increases. So we need to be responsive to maybe the changing needs associated with disability over time. There are several things that I really like about the VA. One is how interdisciplinary the environment is. I regularly have the opportunity to collaborate with experts from across this wide range of domains. So I work with clinicians and programmers and statisticians and mathematicians and fellow social scientists. And it really results in this rich and stimulating environment with so many fresh new ideas. Another thing that I like about VA research is the emphasis on translating research findings into practice. And there's a lot of research that that piece is kind of overlooked, but that's not at all true at VA. And This is evidenced in the strong culture of collaboration between researchers and clinical and operational partners. So it really is a privilege to be engaged in this public service and to continue to work towards that goal of providing the best possible services to those who have served and given so much.